Hello dear friends, welcome to the series of our channel. In this series of our channel, we'll be learning about Merchant of Venice. Yes, now what is Merchant of Venice? It's a play written by William Shakespeare around 400 years ago or even more than that. We all know that William Shakespeare is a playwright, he is a dramatist, he is a playwright. Oh, Merchant of Venice is one of his plays. So that we'll be learning in the text. I hope the text is already there with you. Okay friends, so I'll quickly give you an introduction about the play so that it will be easy for you to follow the text. Okay, now coming to the introduction part. In this play, we see a mixture of feelings in this play. We will see love stories, we will see revenge stories, we will also see friendship, loyalty and truthfulness among the characters of the play. Okay, now coming to the main characters of the play around whom the whole story revolves or the whole drama revolves. Now there are many characters in the play, but some important ones are Antonio, Bassanio, Portia and Shylock. Among these four characters, the whole story revolves. We'll see that. So coming to the main character Antonio, I'll give you a brief description about who Antonio is. Okay friends, so that it will be easy to you for you to connect with the text. Okay. Yes friends, coming to the main character Antonio. Now who Antonio is? Antonio is a rich merchant of Venice, which is the title of the play also. He is a rich merchant of Venice whose business ventures are all at risk at sea. He had this import and export business, and on those days all the business transactions or all the business, this export is import business, were done through ships. So we see that all his merchandise, all his ships are at sea, and he has no ready cash in hand, and his business is not spread in one place, but not staked at one place, but it is spread all over the world, on all the oceans of the world. Okay, now coming to his friends. Now, as Antonio is a reputed man in Venice, because he's a rich businessman, so he had many friends, but Bassanio was one of his best friends, and whom he was always ready to give a helping hand at any cost. We'll see in the play. Now, he was also a Christian, and we also see Antonio in a sad mood all the time. Whenever we'll come across Antonio in the play, we'll see that he is in a melancholy mood, he is in a sad mood. So friends, this was all about the character sketch of Antonio. Let's proceed with Bassanio. Now who Bassanio is, we'll come to know about Bassanio. Yes friends, coming to Bassanio. Now who Bassanio is and what is the role of Bassanio in the play? So Bassanio we see is an extravagant spendthrift. He's a very stylish person and he's an extravagant spendthrift. He's not that rich, and his best friend is Antonio in the play. For all the fulfillment of all his demands, he always goes to Antonio for any kind of help he needed. And Antonio in return was always ready to help him out. He is always ready to give a helping hand to Bassanio at any cost. And Bassanio always was unable to repay back whatever he took from Antonio. Bassanio was unable to repay him back, and Antonio never questioned about anything from Bassanio. Okay, so this was friendship of Antonio and Bassanio. Now coming to Portia. Now Bassanio loves Portia. He will be a suitor to Portia, and ultimately in the play we'll see that he will be able to marry Portia also. So this is a small little description about Bassanio, who Bassanio is and what is the role of Bassanio in the play. Okay, next coming to Portia. Yes friends, so coming to Portia, now who Portia is, what is the role of Portia in the play? So Portia is the princess of Belmont. She is the heiress to the throne of Belmont. Her father is dead, and she is tied by her dead father's will. And we see that she is beauty with brains. She is a very fair lady, intelligent lady. She is beauty with brains. Now what was her dead father's will? We'll come to that. For the time being, we'll just know that she's a princess of Belmont. She also loves Bassanio, and Bassanio will be ultimately able or eligible to marry her. A lot of suitors come to Portia to marry her, But Bassanio will be able or will be eligible to marry her. Now, what was Portia's dead father's will? That will come to that. And so, moving next to Shylock. Now, who Shylock is and what is the role of Shylock in the play? So, moving to Shylock. Yes, Prince. Coming to Shylock. Now, who Shylock is and what is the role of Shylock in the play? We see Shylock is a moneylender of Venice. He is also rich and he is a moneylender of Venice. He is a Jew. He's a shrewd Jew and he dislikes Christians. Okay, now what we'll see in the play? That he will take revenge from Antonio in the play because he dislikes Christians as well as because he has business rivalries with Antonio. Now he also has a daughter named Jessica who loves a character called Lancelot which is disliked by Shylock. Okay, so this is all about Shylock, that he's a moneylender of Venice. And he has business rivalries with Antonio. He is a shrewd Jew. He dislikes Christians. He also dislikes Antonio because he is a Christian also and has business rivalries. And ultimately we see that he has a daughter who loves a character called Lancelot, which is disliked by Shylock. So this is all about the important characters of the play. That is Antonio, Bassanio, Portia and Shylock. Now coming to, let me give you a small description about Portia's dead father's will so that it will be easy for you to move forward, proceed with the text. Okay, so coming to Portia's dead father's will. Coming to Portia's dead father's will, what was the will of her father, of her dead father? Now we see that this will is also very important in the play because ultimately we see the whole drama, the whole play of Merchant of Venice revolves around this will. Now what is, so it's it will be useful to understand this will and before we proceed with the text further. So it will be easy for you to connect with the text. So what was the will of his dead father, of her dead father, sorry. So the will was that her father had planned three caskets before dying. Her father had planned three caskets for her, in one in which her beautiful portrait was kept. Now, these caskets were made of lead, silver and gold. The person who chooses the correct casket in which the beautiful portrait of beautiful Portia was kept will be eligible to marry Portia. This was the will framed by her father who was dead. Okay. Now, so we see ultimately in the play that many suitors come to seek Portia, but they all fail to choose the correct casket or to choose the correct box. Ultimately, Bassanio was able to choose the correct casket and he was able to marry Portia. And she was kept in the lead casket and he was able to justify that chosen casket. The reason why he chose the casket of lead, he was able to justify that. And ultimately, we see that Portia got married to Bassanio. Yes, Prince. So this is the will of Portia's dead father, which is very important. So I've given you into in the introduction class itself, because as we proceed further with the text, it will be helpful for us to connect with the text. Okay, friends. So this was dead father's will. So friends, I will explain you the relationship among the characters in the play with a small diagram here that I have made. Okay, now we see that Antonio and Bassanio are two friends. They are two best friends. We see that Antonio is rich and Bassanio is a spendthrift. Now we see that Bassanio will seek Portia for love and Bassanio will seek Shylock for money, for a loan that he wants from his friend Antonio. Now Antonio in return, Bassanio wanted a loan from his friend Antonio and Antonio in return had no present cash, had no ready cash in hand because all his business ventures, all his merchandise are at risk at sea. So he had no ready cash, but he advised Bassanio to take money or to lend money from money lenders in Venice in the name of Antonio, who had a goodwill, who had a good goodwill, who had a good reputation in Venice because he was a rich businessman. So he had a good credit in the market. So he advised Bassanio to take a loan or to lend money from the money lenders in Venice. So ultimately Bassanio went to Shylock for this loan that he wanted from Antonio because he wanted to be presentable as a suitor to Portia. He wanted to reach Belmont as a prince, and for this he needed money, which he sought help from Antonio, and Antonio advised him to take money or to lend money from moneylenders in Venice. On whose credit? On Antonio's credit, because nobody will give Bassanio any loan because he was a spendthrift. But everybody will give loan to Bassanio on the credit of Antonio. So he went to Shylock for this credit. Now Shylock in return was ready to give the loan, but in what terms and conditions? As I told you in the character sketch, Shylock was a shrewd Jew. He hated Christians, and Antonio was a Christian, and Shylock was a Jew. So he also had business rivalries with Antonio also. So this golden opportunity that Antonio's best friend is coming to take money from Shylock, this golden opportunity Shylock took, and Shylock in return, what's the terms and conditions he set? He gave that 3,000 ducats what Bassanio wanted, but the terms and conditions he said that if Bassanio and Antonio were unable to pay back the amount on the given period of time, then Shylock will be taking a pound of flesh from Antonio's body to fulfill his revenge or to fulfill his loan, which Bassanio and Antonio agreed for. So we'll see in the play as we proceed further. So this small character sketch I gave you so that it will be easy for you to connect with the text. Hope friends, the text is already there with you. So in my further videos, I'll go by the explanation of the speeches as in how we proceed with the acts and scenes of the play. Okay friends, I hope this little introduction that I gave you about the relationship of the characters, among the characters, what relationship is there among the characters of the play, will help you in learning the text more thoroughly. Okay friends, thank you.